So yes, I raced in the 70s and then started off having a family, building a business. Motor racing takes a little bit of a back step. And then when I was in a position to get back into it, kids were a bit older, I then looked to go into Group A because I raced in Group C, so I thought I'd get into Group A. So I shopped around, I looked at all sorts of cars, I looked at Sierras, Commodores, Mustangs, and then I saw the HR31 Nissan and I thought, this is a beautiful car, I could manage it myself. And so I bought it, I just loved it. And I raced that for 7 years. So I won the Group A Championship in 2012 in that car. I won the Australian Grand Prix races in 2012, and the car was going as quick as it was going to go. And of course, by that time, I was really involved with Nissan Motorsport, and the opportunity came up to buy the R32, the 1991 Bathurst winning R32. It wasn't completed. It had been brought back from Thailand, and I was able to buy it. And then we completed the restoration on it. And so I raced that in 2015 in the Group A Championship. Of course, such an iconic car, driven by Jim Richards and Mark Scaife, won Bathurst in a record time in 1991. And the race time wasn't beaten for 19 years. So to sit in that car and actually drive it, we built it over a period of a year. And then we took it down to Winton for the very first hit out. Got onto the track at Winton, and by turn two, I was in love. So we then raced it in the 2015 championship, and the car was never beaten. It took out lap records everywhere. It was never beaten. It never DNF'd. It was just a sensational car. But in fact, during that period, whilst it was so much fun to drive, it really did to the historic Group A championship exactly what it did in 1991. When it just whooped the opposition. And to that extent, it was a little bit like taking an Uzi into a knife fight. And so whilst I loved driving the car, I really didn't enjoy racing it that much. So when I knew that I had a serious collector interested in buying the R32, and he bought the 31 as well, I really wanted to continue racing in the category. And so I looked around for a car which was gonna be capable of running in the top, you know, five cars. And there wasn't really a lot around. And a car I'd been interested in before, but was in a collection owned by the Bowden family in Butterham, was this car. And they said this was a car that they were going to keep, they weren't going to sell it. But when they found out that I was actually selling the 32 and was otherwise going to be without a drive for 2016, they then had a reconsideration. And I must say, I was pleased that Chris and David Bowden eventually said, look, you know, we'd like you to continue in the series, and so we're prepared to sell you the Longhurst 1990 car. So that was fantastic. We got that in December 2015. We rebuilt the car in 8 weeks and we took it down to Phillip Island. This was a car that had only raced in 11 race meetings in the day and then had been in the collection for 23 years. We took it down to Phillip Island. I'd never driven the car. Come Friday morning, was qualifying. Took it out. I was a little bit unhappy with how taily it was. Came in after about three laps and we let a bit of pressure out of the rear tyres and went back out and had a crack. Came back in and the time was reasonable. I thought it was a reasonable time. And as it turned out, it was such a good time, I qualified on pole. And we ran it during the series in 2016 and finished second in the championship in 2016 behind the R32 GTR, driven by Tony Orford. And although I came second in 2016, I'd won it in 2015, my GTR, I actually enjoyed the racing in 2016 so much more because I drove the ring off this car just to keep up with that GTR. I really drove hard. I learned so much, helped my skills, and it was just thoroughly enjoyable. So in heritage touring cars, you've got guys who are stewards of these cars and they recognise that they're their owner at the time, but they're really they're just gifted the privilege of looking after this car for a period of time, and then eventually they sell it, and it's a classic that has to be maintained. So people drive a little bit, you know, more sensibly. You don't see cars regularly damaged in these classes, and yet there are cars that, you know, mine in particular and a couple of other guys who are driving them pretty hard compared to how they were driven in the past. We're driving them almost as quickly as they were in the day. So we're having a good old crack, but we recognise this is a valuable property. We want to sell it at the end for more than what we paid for it, and we want to maintain the car so that it's can be there for other people. So Jim's tuned cars for me before in the past. He tuned the 31. He did a fantastic job, and just loved the service. He came out to the track, fine-tuned the car out of the track, and so we've always kept in touch. Now we've rebuilt the engine for this year. We're going to Bathurst tomorrow, and I wanted him to run the car in and to do a tune on it. And I'm glad I brought it, because he's been able to find a little bit more out of the engine, so it's really good. It's 6 hour this weekend, so the Heritage Touring Cars Group A that I'm racing in is on the undercard for that, so we're a support event. It's not a championship event, but it's a prestigious event, you know, to run a Group A at Bathurst. It's just a fantastic experience. So yeah, we want to have a serious crack at being in the top three out there on the weekend, and I think we've got the car to do it.